The Guy, Sharyn and Clint podcast.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Guy, Sharyn and Clint podcast.
Hi, guys. Welcome along to the podcast.
Hi, guys. This is the podcast, and I would just like to say, welcoming you to the podcast. Do you think anyone's noticed that we didn't come up with an idea for the intro to the podcast, guys?
I came up with an idea for the podcast.
What is it?
If you'd like to hear it.
If it's welcome to the music, you are arrested and you're banned from doing podcast intros for next week.
First up, what is welcome to the music?
Oh, whatever. Thank you for the music or the song you sing in the intro every time.
All right. Well, I'm out of ideas. What have you guys got?
I'm glad that I threatened you and you pulled out though. I'm glad that you want to do the intros next week.
No, it's just I don't have time to concentrate because I'm looking for a new Twitter profile pic.
She said before, Clint, that she was going to try and find one of me and her so I can cut me out of it. She's going to shot me out of her photo. Come on. And I'm like, why would I want to be in your Twitter profile pic anyway?
Today on the show, we had life hacks happening. We had...
It was actually not a great life hacks, but do you know what was amazing?
What?
Our AMA.
I was getting there. You didn't cut me off, mate.
I just wanted to talk about, because life hacks is one of my babies, and I'm really sad when it doesn't
fire.
Whoa.
Hey, look, mate. We can talk about your babies as well, if you want.
Yeah. No, but
I hate your baby. Your baby's got a bad attitude. Yeah, life and it always hacks. Cries.
It did this week.
And it pooed on my carpet.
Absolutely.
Also, Sharyn's revolutionary new features, What's in Guy's Mouth and the Long Weekend Chahu.
The long weekend Chahu is not to be matched. The AMA is with Michael Galvin, a.k.a. What's his name?
Chris Warner
from Shortland Street. Yeah.
Check it out.
Guy, Sharyn and Clint.
It's Friday. That means...
Guy, Sharyn and Clint.
Stop bragging about it.
Oh, yeah. This is the part of the week where you get to call us on 0800 The Edge or text us to 3343 and brag about something awesome that happened to you this weekend, or it could be something you're doing this long weekend.
Can I start?
Sure.
Someone crashed into my car and it was a real down buzz, and then I had to take it to get panel beaten, and I finally got it back today and it's come back and it's all fixed and they cleaned it. So after the car crash, I've actually got a better car than I had before because it's clean.
Good on you, girl. What about you, guy? Anything to brag about?
Someone crashed into my car a couple of weeks ago and I still haven't got it fixed, but I'm cool with that. I'm satisfied. I'm fine with it.
Good.
Sweet.
Brag.
Good for you, bro.
My brag is that tomorrow I'm going to meet my niece, Madeline, for the first time. Quite excited. Quite excited. First baby out of my siblings. It's quite cool. Glad it wasn't me. Now, Carly, what would you like to brag about?
I wanted to brag about, I just went to go and buy some wine and I got ID.
Oh yeah, there is no better feeling. How old are you actually?
I am 37 years old.
You're 37.
And the fact you still look 17 is impressive, babes.
Carly, do you think the guy was trying to hit on you?
I think he was too young to know anybody over the age of 21 actually.
Dylan, what do you want to brag about?
I asked my girlfriend's dad if I could marry his daughter yesterday, and he said yes.
Whoa! Have you popped the big question to her yet?
No, in the next couple of months she'll have it.
Save it up.
Dylan, we should use a bloody fake name. What if she's heard this? Now you're going to have to propose like in 5 minutes.
That's right. She's up for me, so it doesn't bother me.
Oh, brilliant.
Oh, nailed it. What did he? Was it hard? Was it an awkward thing to do?
Well, I took him to the pub and got him a little bit drunk, so it was a lot easier.
So what if he doesn't remember it?
I got it on video.
Oh, yes. Genius. Good on you. Congrats, Dylan. Hello, Graham.
Hi, guys. How are you?
Good,
Graham texted in and said that he's bragging and over the moon that little old New Zealand has developed some world-leading technology in the fishing rod industry.
Yeah, we have.
Graham, is this your own company that are you bragging about?
Well, it is, and it's in conjunction with a New Zealand leading company.
So yeah, okay.
We share the IP, and we've developed what's called the XPT mandrel, and that's basically where you roll the blank to make the fishing rod, and it's allowed us to make these blanks lighter, stronger, and thinner than any other blank on the market.
Graham, you're talking to a bunch of fishing novices here, but basically you've invented a better fishing rod?
It's a better fishing rod all around.
And
definitely.
Now it's God's move to create a better fish.
Congratulations, Graham. We have no idea what you're talking about, mate, but I love your enthusiasm, and that's what it's all about. Kia kaha, mate.
Liz, what are you bragging about?
I'm bragging because I won an awesome competition from you guys not that long ago, and I get to go out on the Auckland town tomorrow night to Blacklist and show off my new wardrobe with my new hot body.
Yeah! So, once again, you won the competition, and did we pay you $2,900?
Yep, $2,900. So I've gone and got a complete new wardrobe looking stunning thanks to you guys.
Because we gave you $1,000 per kg that
$100.
You lost.
$100. Yep, per kg, and I lost 29 kg. So I finally get to show my body off, not only in Hamilton, but I'm coming up to Auckland to ruin your town.
She's on tour. Catch her in Hamilton, catch her in Auckland.
Yeah. Congratulations. Let's enjoy that, mate. Good brag.
And Bex, you're last. What's yours?
I'm bragging because I got $2,000 in a tax refund.
Yes! That is awesome.
What are you going to blow it on? Do something stupid.
Probably clothes.
Oh, that is stupid. Good effort.
I love that. Hey, we're also going to hook you up with a Lotto Powerball ticket for this weekend's draw, okay?
Thank you.
No worries.
Aw, to finish on an aw, someone texts in saying, I want to brag that my boyfriend told me that he loves me for the first time.
Aw.
Aw. What a nice way to finish the segment.
Guy, Sharyn and Clint. Edge.
In the studio with us right now, the Edge's resident butt-toucher, Chang Tung.
Allegedly.
Chang Tung.
Allegedly, my lawyer says do not admit anything, so... Yeah.
Well, my husband actually came through and told Chang off today for being the butt-toucher. If you missed the show yesterday, we exposed Chang for notoriously touching bottoms of female staff around the office.
Allegedly.
You looked a little scared when Bryce came through, though, and was like, stop touching my wife's bum.
He was very serious.
Well, how do you not think
he's serious?
That's
his bum, mate. He put a ring on that bum.
Yeah. Okay.
That sounded bad. So the point is...
Then you should put a ring on it.
The point is it's hard to get through to Chang. Even physical, like, threatening from Bryce, which is basically like he came and staunched him out, wasn't enough to change him. So we've got to go to desperate measures, guys, which is we're going to get a custom-made butt-toucher fluoro vest made for Chang with a constant like beeping so a woman know when he's in the proximity.
We could just put a cat bell on him. So
I'm not an animal.
That's way cheaper. Well, you're acting like one.
No, it's going to be a custom vest. It's going to be bright orange, and it's going to have a flashing light that goes beep. Beep.
Okay, well,
beep.
We're going to put you...
Whenever you hear it, you know the butt touches in charge.
We're going to put you in charge of that. So next week, you have to bring the vest.
I'm going to make
which
it.
Which means we're never going to see the vest and we're going to end up getting a cat bell.
Chang the Office Butt Toucher has prepared his segment for us weekly. It's called Cream of the Crap. Right here are Chang's highlights from the last 5 days.
Guy, Sharyn and Clint's Cream of the Crap. During the week, we had Guy Williams' dad on the phone.
Are you proud of your son?
Oh, yeah, very much so, yep.
Really?
It's great having a crap celebrity as a son. Yeah. I couldn't wish for anything more. I just wish he'd take his clothes off for a few more magazines. That's what I wish.
He was referring to Guy Williams' nude on the front cover of the Metro magazine, which is in stores now. This week's How Does It Feel? To pee on an electric fence. We came into a little bit of a problem.
Hang on, how am I going to do this?
Yeah, actually, that's a very good question. Chang, have we factored Sharon's lady parts into this week's How Does It Feel?
I've tried tried peeing standing up before, and I lean back and just eat all over my legs.
So, can
you not aim?
What would I have you seen a lady's parts before?
As an expert on women.
Hang on, no, that's a good question. Chang, have you seen a lady's parts before?
Of course I have. Come on, guys. So Clint's name was spun on the wheel and he had to pee on the electric fence.
Nothing. Nothing.
Turn it off!
I've had to pinch it off midstream. I've still got more wheeze to come out.
How?
You can check out the video on our website, theedge.co.nz. Also during the week, Guy and Clint got really creepy with one of our callers, Natalie.
What are your thoughts on this no bra needed scenario?
Well, I think women need bras. I mean, sure, it feels great to take them off and I can't wait to get home to take mine off.
I can't wait to watch you. Wait. No, that was weird.
Oh, my God.
I would like to help you take that power off.
Yes, that was a little bit creepy. And finally, during the week, I got accused of being a butt toucher.
Every day when I come to work, I'm being subjected to butt touches from Chang Hung.
That'll do, eh? No, Thank God for voice disguise, because I just couldn't even tell him.
I turned the voice disguise off there at the end.
Whatever, Sharyn. If you miss anything on our show this week, you can catch it on our podcast on iTunes or video on our website, theedge.co.nz. Have a good Queen's Birthday weekend.
Guy, Sharyn and Clint.
On The Edge.
Two things you haven't complimented me on today. One is my new haircut. The other is the fact that I was on time today, guys. We've talked about this. We've gone, Guy, you're never on time. You're a dickhead, mate.
You weren't on time.
So I've started turning on time. I've made a special effort both yesterday and today, nailing it.
You were like half an hour late.
You weren't on time. You were supposed to be here at 12:25. And then
You told me I could come in 12:45.
Yeah, and you came in at what time?
12:45.
You came in at 12:53.
Close enough. I was in the ballpark. Congratulations to me. Well done. That's a good effort.
Have you had a haircut?
Yeah.
Is that why you were late?
No.
Because like
that was why I was late to my other job.
Yesterday, do you know that I snapped out Guy so bad yesterday. I was driving back from an appointment and I saw Guy.
Late.
I had told everyone I was going to be late. He was taking a photo with his phone of a poster on the street and I rang him because he was supposed to be at work. I rang him and he goes, I'm on my way, I'm not far. And I said, no, you're not. I'm looking at you taking a photo of a poster. And you're like, And then he hung up on me and wouldn't answer his phone when I rang back.
Would you be, Sharyn, would you be as mad with me if I told you that I was taking some great pics for Instagram?
Whose Instagram?
Mine.
No, maybe if you're using the Guy Sharyn and Clint Instagram.
It turned into some great entertainment, guys. I took a shot of the New Zealand Music Month poster that I saw, and I was like, guys, I finally found it, the poster they put up for New Zealand Music Month. And I also took a photo of the Homeite Paki Paki from Māori TV poster, and I said, this is going to be me next year when I'm hosting Homeite Paki Paki.
Well, you need to learn how to say the name of the show first.
Yeah. My Te Rero isn't up to scratch, but once I figure that out, I'm going to be away, mate.
You were such a disgrace.
I'm a good guy, and I'm on time, so congratulate me later, guys.
You weren't on time, but your haircut looks good.
Guy, Sharyn and Clint. Itch. Life hack. Entry granted.
Welcome into the life hacks. I just wanted to do that because Guy loves introducing life hacks.
You took it away.
And your mic's not even on.
We haven't even turned your microphone on yet.
Just to sabotage me.
Yeah, you're not even part. Still not part of the segment.
Am I still not? Yeah.
Am I on now?
Yeah, now you're here.
Life
Thank
hack.
You so much, guys. Okay, so text in the 3343 if you've got an awesome life hack for us, or call us on 0800 The Edge. Let's kick off with some easy ones from the text machine. This one's from me, Guy Williams. Save time on Facebook by not checking your Facebook.
Life hack. Entry granted.
Did you text the text machine just so you could read it out?
This one's from @UncleBillD on Twitter. If you choose the red pill, you get to leave the Matrix. That is a good one.
Life hack. Entry granted.
I have no idea what that means.
Sharyn looks at, well, you know how at the start of the Matrix.
It's not actually correct, though.
The only thing that I know about the Matrix is the dance move everyone would do when they would like lean back and be like,
So have you not seen The Matrix?
No, I find Keanu Reeves depressing.
That is, yeah, but this is good Keanu Reeves. Oh my god.
This is like Point Break Keanu Reeves.
Okay, you go watch The Matrix and we'll count with these life hacks.
Okay.
Here's a good genuine one. Here's a life hack for you. It's from the text machine. If you have a Mozzie bite, get a teaspoon and soak it in boiling water, then press it to the bite and the itching will stop.
That's true. I did that the other night and it definitely works.
If you have a Mozzie bite, just burn it off.
Life hack. Entry granted.
Someone said it kills the protein responsible for the itch.
Ooh.
Here's another genuine one. Take your gym gear to work so you don't get a chance to talk yourself out of it at home.
That's true. That's
Do you know,
true.
I did that last night, actually. I not take it to work. I slept in my gym gear so that when I woke up this morning, I wasn't like, oh, I can't be bothered getting out of bed and getting dressed. I just took off the duvets and I was ready to go to the gym.
Good on you, mate. Yeah, that sounds cool.
Life hack. Entry.
It's very cold at the moment. They're not motivating.
We got Kirk on the phone right now. Kirk, you've actually got 3 life hacks. What are they?
Yeah, man. The first one, grab a bag of chips, open them up, and to get them to stand up next to you, just tuck in the bottom corner up into it. It pushes the chips up and you can just let it sit there.
Ah, delicious life hack.
Life hack. Entry granted.
And number 2, Kirk?
Number 2, grab an empty toilet roll, just cut a little slit in the top of it, so lie it down on it. Sorry, cut a little top. and put your iPhone into it, and it works as a speaker, amplifies the sound.
Okay, that's good. I thought you were going to say it was a stand. We've had that one a few times. But toilet roll speaker's good. That'll set the party off.
Entry granted. And let's see if we can do 3 out of 3. Kirk, what's the last one?
If you're constipated, sit on the toilet and rock back and forth.
Alrighty. Wow. Life hack. Life not
hacked. No entry permissible. Kirk, 2 out of 3 ain't bad, bro. Don't worry about it. That was pretty good.
I can go worse than that. Do you want one worse than that?
Quickly.
From Twitter, at Filthy Richmond. You know those Coke lids they have when you buy a Coke from McDonald's on the top of the cup lid? You use the lid of a soft drink as a spoon rest for your butt plug. That's really good. That's a good one. Not hacked. No entry permission. Oh, that was good.
Call us
now. I didn't realise we had a barrel in here to scrape.
Here's some genuinely quite good ones. Peanut butter on a mouse trap, not cheese, makes mice lick it and get trapped easier.
Ooh.
That's a good one. Clint's not impressed.
No, okay. No, I am.
Peanut butter instead of cheese. Life hack. Entry granted. I thought that was really good. If you weren't impressed with that one, these are all going to be worse.
I just didn't think like a little mouse with his little mouse tongue. Is his little mouse tongue enough to trigger the trap? I thought he had to like climb up on his paws and like try and.
He's going to get on the peanut butter and he's like, oh my god, it's like crack, and then he'll climb up on the cheese and then bam.
But isn't it the cheese, the weight of the cheese coming off the trap that sets off the trap? I'm confused.
No, it's the downward pressure that sets the trap off.
Oh man, I need to.
Kill more mice.
Yeah. Wash an avocado in water once it's cut to stop it from going brown.
Well, that's pretty good.
That is a really good one. Life hack. Entry granted. Pez, what's your life hack?
Basically, you get a bottle of water, 1.5 litre works the best, and you freeze it on its side in the freezer, fill it up with water in the morning, and you've got cold water all day. Wicked for missions to the beach and playing sports.
Not bad at all.
Granted. Boom. Good work, Haz. Thanks for that
one. Also, if you have ice cream, or everyone likes ice cream, but you can also put it in a Ziploc bag in the freezer, and it'll be like a new tub every time you eat it.
I thought his life hack was just going to be, just have ice cream. Life hack.
Charles, what's your life hack?
My life hack is getting all your work done an hour early, then you leave and you still get paid for that extra hour.
Woo! Yes, that is called good time management.
We can't do that because our show finishes at 7, and if we got all our work done, we'd be like, we're done at 6 p.m. and we've still got an hour to go.
Well, I'm currently driving home and I'm still getting paid.
Dang!
I've got a similar one. Work at regular speed, if not a little bit slower, and over the course of the day, spend an hour in the toilet. That way you get paid for an hour where you were just hanging out in the toilet.
Yeah. Oh, I do that as well, mate. I do that as well, and I still get all my work done.
What's your name?
Charles.
Where do you work?
In Penrose, Auckland.
I'm calling your boss right now.
Thanks, Charles. Life hack. Yep. Entry granted. There you go, that's life hacks for another week. Guy, Sharyn
and Clint. On the bloody edge.
It's that time, just you and me together. It's that time, that special time of day. It's that time to play a new game. It's called What's in Guy's Mouth.
Da-dum, dum.
This is
What's
moronic.
What's in Guy's Mouth.
Da-dum, dum.
I hate this.
What's in Guy's Mouth. Ba-dum, we're about to find out. That's a jingle I made up just then.
So explain to the people how What's in Guy's Mouth works.
Okay, well, because a lot of people text in and say, can you please shut Guy Williams up? I thought, how can I do this? And then I remembered a game that I used to play about 10 years ago on a radio show I had in Marston called What's in Your Mouth, but then I decided to call it What's in Guy's Mouth so that we can make him shush.
Was this coming from Radio Masterton? Shout out to Radio Masterton.
Thank you.
When we pitched this idea in our brainstorm before the show, believe it or not, we do brainstorm these things, Guy's suggestion was,
do you think we should do it with Chang? Because I'm worried that if we do it with me, I won't be able to talk during the break. And I normally have the best things to say.
And I spit hot fire.
So what we're going to do is we're going to put something in Guy's mouth. And then he is going to try and tell you what it is. And if you can guess what's in Guy's mouth, then you, my friend, will win a prize. Now, I'm going to give you a hint for today's thing. It is not a thing. It is multiples of this thing.
Okay.
And we're going to put them in Guy's mouth now. So if you just put your head back, I'll put them all in your mouth.
You'll hear them going in, and you're welcome to start calling now on 0800 The Edge.
Oh, I touched your tooth.
Guess what's in Guy's mouth.
One more. Keep it one more.
Can you not get any more in there?
More? Okay, more. We've got 8 in so far. Okay, I'm stuffing it in the side. I'm going to put the last 2 in.
Okay. Guy, we need you to tell us exactly what is in your mouth. What is it? Okay, 0800 okay. The Edge, what's in Guy's mouth? Renee, would you like to have the first guess?
I'm going to go with straws.
Straws?
Yeah.
Have you got straws in your mouth, Guy? Oh, no. We'll have to leave them in there and come back to you very soon.
We've got another one.
Oh, okay, we've got another guess. Okay, what's the second guess?
Royden, what's in Guy's mouth?
Are they marshmallows?
One more time. Don't say anything else on. Except
well, one more time. What is it? No idea.
Well, if you think you know what's in Guy's mouth, call us 0800 The Edge.
This is a great game. Does he have to keep that in there while the song's on?
Yep.
Guy is choking on whatever's in his mouth.
Just put your head back, babes. I forgot how much fun this game was. Brad and I, when we used to do the night show together, remember Brad? We used to do this every night, and there's just nothing more fun than shoving your co-host's mouth full of stuff.
That's what Brad used to say as well.
I never had to put anything in my mouth. It was always Brad.
Oh, okay. But must have been with Marty then.
We've got something in Guy's mouth. What's in your mouth, Guy?
Okay, we can't take out what's in Guy's mouth until someone guesses what is in Guy's mouth. So, shall we take our time?
Excuse me. We'll take our time. Who's our first caller?
Our first caller, Sharyn, on line 2 is Hamish. Hello, Hamish.
Hi, Hamish.
Hello.
How's your day going?
Going pretty good.
Oh, that's good. Anything else you want to tell us so that we can keep this thing in Guy's mouth for a while? Nah.
Not much.
Okay, cool. What do you think's in Guy's mouth?
I reckon it's grapes.
Grapes? Have you got grapes in your mouth, Guy? No, it's not grapes.
Guys. Sorry, Hamish. Catch you later. Next person on the phone is Bree. Hello, Bree.
Hi.
What's in Guy's mouth, Bree?
Is it onion?
Onion! Are you saying no? No, okay, no.
Is it yes, it is onion?
No, it's not onion?
No,
there's not that, sorry, Bree. Okay, we've got
to... Shall we read through some of the text message options
first? Yeah, let's go through the text messages.
Okay, some people have texted in key rings. Is it key rings?
No, is it key rings?
Is it Sharyn's undies long? Are there pillows in Guy's mouth? Wheatbix? Clothes pegs? Tampons? Jono or Ben's penis?
All right, let's go to our last caller. Cole, what do you think it is?
Oh, I know what it is. It's tea bags.
Yes! It is teabags, Cole. Congratulations. I have officially teabagged Guy live on air.
Thank you so much, Cole, for freeing me from that hell.
Cole, you've just...
Yeah, why not? Yeah.
Cole, they were disgusting.
You just won for yourself 10 soggy teabags direct from Guy Williams' mouth.
10 soggy teabags, is that all I get?
Nah, we're going to send you a little Lotto Powerball ticket, man, for the $23 million draw this weekend.
Hey guys, can I do a shout out while I'm on here?
Yeah, go for it.
Go on, babe.
Okay, hopefully my foreman's listening. I just wanted to say that he's a douchebag and he should get teabagged.
Oh, no, you didn't.
Guy, Sharyn and Clint.
On the Edge.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the studio, direct from the streets of Shortland, Michael Galvin, Chris Warner.
Thank you and good afternoon. Good evening.
I am so excited that you are here.
I'm excited too.
This is awesome. Can I have the first question in the AMA?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay.
Would you like to ask it right now?
I want to ask it
now. Go for it.
Okay.
Please do.
Michael.
Hi.
I was listening to The Edge about 10 years ago and I remember JJ saying that Shortland Street actors always go to the supermarket at 7 p.m. because all the Shortland Street fans wouldn't be at the supermarket so you could do your shopping in peace. Is this true?
It is the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard in my life.
Oh, man. Do you know how many times I have gone to the Flash countdowns in Ponsonby at 7 o'clock, hoping to see someone
I've
from
seen,
Shortland Street.
I've seen her at the Countdown supermarket once or twice. It wasn't even at 7 o'clock. It was during the day.
Oh, damn it.
She was having you on. She was lying to you, and you believed her.
I've been believing that for 10 years.
What are the questions you've always wanted to know? There's still time to text them through. We've got some people on the phones already. And next, we find out everything we've ever wanted to know from Chris Warner, a.k.a. Michael Galvin, a.k.a. Dr. Love, a.k.a. any other names?
Dr. Flab.
And you can ask anybody. Go ahead and ask anybody. Yeah, you can ask anybody. Anything, anything, anything.
I love it. It's growing on me every week.
Really?
Yeah, I've got it now.
Oh, good. I'm glad you're enjoying it now.
What did you think, Michael? Did you like the song?
Yeah. No. I thought it was scary.
We'll take that. It is quite scary.
Our guest this afternoon for AMA is Michael Galvin from Shortland Street.
Hi,
he plays
everyone.
Dr. Chris Warner. Have you ever played any other characters on there, like some of the people on the show? You've only ever been Dr. Chris Warner, haven't you?
Yeah, it would be a little confusing if I played another character, don't
but
you think?
But it does happen, doesn't it?
You mean like my own twin?
Yeah.
Or something.
Some actors return as different characters, though, sometimes, don't they?
Yeah, but not me.
Okay, good.
It doesn't often happen that they return it. Yeah, if you've got a tiny
When you
part,
die,
you
could be
back.
The ghost of Chris Warner.
I could.
You can't ask that. Michael is like the Richie McCaw of Shortland Street.
Oh, that's very sweet.
He can only play Chris Warner or Chris Warner's evil twin, like Daryl Nielsen.
So we're all dressed up in official medical gear. Here's your stethoscope.
Thank you.
Chris Warner has a white jacket on. Are you impressed by our costumes?
Yeah, sure. I guess impressed is one word. So you're New Zealand's sexiest man, are you?
I am indeed.
That's pretty bad for the rest of us. If that's what the New Zealand sexiest man looks like.
That was actually one of my first questions for you, actually. Uh-huh. Was how did TK, Ben Mitchell, take it that I beat him for New Zealand's sexiest man?
Okay, as far as he is concerned, you are not New Zealand's sexiest man. He is. Ben lives in an impervious bubble, and you can say what you like, you can show him any evidence you like, and he will believe the thing that is good for him.
All right.
I love
good
Ben.
Good answer.
I love Ben.
The costumes that Guy's referring to, we have Dr. Sharyn Casey over here.
Good evening.
Dr. Michael Galvin in the lab coat.
I concur.
Nurse Guy Williams in a beautiful, are we calling this fuchsia or lavender?
It's fuchsia.
Fuchsia.
Kia ora.
Nurse's dress.
I've spiced
good
up my
colour naming.
I've spiced up my nurse's dress with a cowboy hat as well, just to give it a bit more of a vibe.
And I thought I had a nice bluey green.
Dude, you look like you should be at a supermarket.
I thought it was a nurse. Sharyn said I looked like a checkout operator.
Is that teal?
I was going to go with teal, but I was nervous that I'd get the colour wrong.
I think it's teal.
It's time to open up the lines and ask me anything with Dr. Chris Warner from Shortland Street.
We're going to go to the phone straight away. Karen, you are on with Michael Galvin. What is your question?
Hello.
Karen.
Hey, my
Karen's not there. We'll try Christina. Christina, what's your question?
No, line two's now Tom.
Oh, Tom, what's your question?
Hey, how's it going?
Good. What's your question for Michael?
My question is what is your most embarrassing blooper moment while recording?
His question was, what has been your most embarrassing blooper moment to date on Shortland Street?
Ooh, that is
sorry,
a good
buddy, got to change headphones. My most embarrassing blooper moment. I can't really think of them. One.
Did you have any bloopers when you were doing the flying fox?
That whole thing was one big blooper. Yeah. I had an embarrassing moment that wasn't on Shortland Street. I was in a pub. I accidentally spat beer in this girl's face.
Oh no!
That's terrible.
Did they get it on camera? Did they use the take?
No, nobody filmed it. Thank God.
Oh, that is very, very lucky, Emily.
Yeah, no, I just coughed on it, you know, and it just went.
Hi there.
Hi.
My question is: when you're filming scenes with the person who plays Harry and he's acting like a little brat, do you ever have the urge to punch him like the viewers do? Or?
No. Honestly, Reed is the coolest, sweetest guy.
No, not the kid, the character. We're not picking on the kid.
Punch the character.
Just the character of Harry.
Well, no, because I know it's Reed and it's illegal. And I'd be fired.
Oh,
good answer.
No, I know. I'm glad you feel like punching him though, because that's the intent, of course, of the storyline.
He does a great job of acting as a little brat, right?
He does. He does.
He's
the exact opposite of that. He is the most professional member of the cast by a long way.
Wow!
He always knows his lines. He always does exactly what he's.
You've opened yourself up there. Who's the most unprofessional member of the cast?
Oh.
That's tough because they usually don't last that long.
Let's think of someone that came in and then left real fast.
I can't say. I don't want to dish.
Chuck something else as an AMA, mate. You've got to have an answer.
I can't think of who might be the least professional.
Oh, Percy. Chicken.
Keep the questions coming in for the AMA.
If it comes to me later on, I'll tell you.
Here's one from the text machine. Hi. Do you get free medical care if you turn up to the hospital in costume?
Do I?
Yeah.
Which... Turn up to which medical...
To a real hospital, if you're sick.
Well, but surely if I turned up, I'd be a doctor and not a patient. So it would be me giving the medical care, wouldn't it? And the answer is yes, I sometimes do turn up and do impromptu surgeries. Because it's fun. And they let me do it.
Great call.
And you can ask anybody.
Oh, my goodness. Go ahead and ask
anybody. Can't stop it once it started.
You can ask anybody.
Better the second time around?
Yeah, it's growing on me.
Yeah, good.
Hey, I've just remembered the least professional cast member.
Yeah.
And I'm sorry to say this, it's Temuera Morrison. And I'm not saying he's not a great human being and a great actor, because he's both of those things. But when he came back onto Shortland Street, we kind of managed to entice him back. I think it was for the 20th anniversary.
Yeah.
And I think we talked him into it when we were all pretty drunk at the Christmas party. And so he said, yeah, why not? And he came back and they really thrashed him. They made him, they gave him all these lines and they gave him all these things he didn't want to do, like cry and all this kind of stuff. And some days he just wouldn't turn up. Or he'd go, I'm not working on Thursdays. And just
amazing.
Come to work on Thursday.
I heard a rumor that he didn't learn his lines and they had to write his lines on the back of extras.
no, but he did give his lines to other. If he was in a big ED scene with other doctors, he'd go, oh, you take that one. You take that line. You know, and I'll say, I concur.
No way.
Yeah. That is awesome. Legend.
If you've just joined us, Michael Galvin is in the studio with us at the moment. We're doing an AMA.
And we've got some questions from our Facebook page as well. First question: out of all of the women that Chris Warner has married on Shortland Street, apart from Rachel, who is your favourite Shortland Street wife? Yeah. Or baby mama?
So terrible to have to choose.
Daniel
Cormack was pretty awesome.
She played Alison?
She plays Alison. She's an amazing career in Australia now. She's a brilliant actress.
That is who I was hoping you would say.
I like Laura too. She's lovely.
There's a lot to choose from. Yeah. Why do you keep on killing your wives, Chris?
Well, why not? Because I can. It's not me. It's the staircase.
On the back of that, someone's asking, how does your real wife feel about all the women you've been with on the show?
She's not that concerned because I'm divorced.
Oh, wow, well, that solves that problem.
Well, that works out. Next question. Some days do you wake up and just wish that you would get killed off Shortland Street because you are sick of people yelling, Chris Warner, at you in the street?
Okay, first thing, if I left Shortland Street, they would still yell that at me. That's going to happen for the rest of my life,
good
and
point.
I'm totally at peace with that.
Yeah.
And I genuinely love the job. I genuinely love it. You know, I wake up and think, oh, good, I'm going to work. I mean, so obviously some days are worse than others, but on the whole, I absolutely love it. So, no. The last thing I want to be now.
Sharyn, what a lovely answer.
Let's take some phone calls now.
Yeah, we've got Shane on the line. What's your question for Michael?
Does anyone actually think you're a real doctor?
I'm not sure about that, you know, because people who play doctors and, you know, they say, people keep asking me for real advice at parties. I think, and the conclusion I've come to is, I do think they think I'm a real doctor, but they think I'm a crap doctor, so they don't want my advice. And that's why they're not coming up to me. It's like, oh, he's a doctor. It's like, oh, no, I won't ask him because those four people died in that last operation he did. Because there was a spate where every week someone would die on his surgery table. So so yes and no, I guess, is the answer to that.
I'm just saying, if something goes wrong and I need an operation, if we can't get a hold of McDreamy from Grey's Anatomy, then they're going to have to try and find you. Because you're the only guys
I
trust. The only ones I trust. Nicole, what's your question?
Hi.
Hi.
I'm just wondering why you think your character of Chris Warner has lasted so long on the show, because it's lasted the whole time, hasn't it?
I really don't know. I'm not sure. I think it's because I'm willing to give things a go, you know. Like they'll make Chris do certain things, and I'll give that a go to the best of my ability, and kind of throw myself into it. And often they're kind of crazy things.
Yeah. In terms of the flying fox, you literally did throw yourself into it.
No, that was a stunty that that got the real brain damage.
Do you have a stunt double?
Pardon?
Do you have a stunt double?
Yeah, they have. They have. Do you guys not know how this works?
No. This is why we have you here.
We're learning. We're learning quickly.
Yeah. Well, if it's something dangerous, they'll get a stuntie to do it. I mean, I'll kind of do a version of it, and they'll get a stuntie to do a proper version of it.
Has there ever been a scene that you've read over in the script and you've thought, I'm sorry, but I am not doing that?
Oh yeah, that happens a lot. Yeah.
What were?
Well, you know this
example?
Well, no, I'm not doing it. But it's like, how are we going to sell this? Like, you know this whole thing with like Rachel and Chris and Grace and the baby, and Rachel's like, oh no, you guys go upstairs and have sex, and have a baby.
Yeah.
No, Chris, no, you have a baby to another woman, and all three of us were kind of like, whoa, has anyone heard of this happening in real life?
Yeah, they should have had that conversation when Nicole married herself as well. That was weird.
We've got to go to line one, Kathleen, because Kathleen's been waiting a long time. Kathleen, what's your question?
When people see you in public, do they treat you as a nobody, or do they actually make a big deal out of it?
It's a bit of both. Yeah, I do sometimes get. It depends where I go. If I go to a place with lots of kids, there'll be a. You know, there'll be a lot of yelling, and it's all good. It's all good. It's all good. They never call me by my name. It's always Shortland Street Guy. Guy of Shortland Street.
Great.
I've decided that's what I'm going to put on my tombstone. Here lies the Guy of Shortland Street.
Thanks, Kathleen.
Just leave it at that.
And you can ask anybody.
He's into it.
And you can ask anybody.
Yeah, you can ask anybody. Anything at all. Anything
at all. Oh, no, sorry.
Michael Galvin is here. He plays Chris Warner on Shortland Street, and he has been and is our guest for this afternoon's Ask Me Anything.
And it is an honour to have you in the studio.
The honour is all mine.
I've worked here for 8 years. Do you know how hard it is to get an interview with you?
Oh, is it?
It is hard. It's really hard.
Oh, okay.
I've been trying for a really long time.
Well, let's kick off with the question.
Okay, here is your question. Why, this is from Facebook, why didn't you just become a real doctor? Because you've played Chris longer than if you'd actually trained to be a doctor.
Because being a real doctor is hard, and acting is easy, and being a real doctor is a little icky and sick people, and being an actor, you get your makeup and your costume. And yes, but it's a good question.
You can wear makeup as a doctor if you like.
You can do anything.
From Twitter, how many roles have you turned down to continue being on Shortland Street?
Oh, it's not. Well, there are things. Yeah, people kind of ask me to do other things, just kind of small little cameo things on TVNZ, but I have to kind of turn them down because I'm so close to identify Shortland Street. Oh, I don't know. Not many. Nothing too important.
Huge fans, Emma and Maureen, want to know, if you weren't on Shortland Street, what show would you love to do?
Mad Men is my favourite show.
God, I love Mad Men.
Good choice.
I love that show.
Are you up to date?
I want to be married to Megan because she's just so hot. Yeah. I am up to date.
I'm about three episodes behind. Oh, it's the best show.
It's fantastic.
Oh, good.
Show.
All right, good.
Or Game of Thrones.
Yeah. Who could forget? It's a classic.
That'd be good. Another question from one of our Facebook friends. Do you think the producers of Shortland Street will want to freeze you and Angela, who plays Rachel, so that they can continue Rachel and Chris storylines for the next 40 years or so?
They don't need to freeze us. They just need to pay for our surgery, you know, and the Botox and all the rest of it.
Fair play. I'd do that as well. We've got some phone call. Oh, thanks, Brian.
Crikey.
Hannah, what's your question for Michael?
Hi, Hannah.
Who's your favourite person to work with on set?
Probably Angela, because me and her, Angela Bloomfield, who plays Rachel, we go way, way back. We're kind of like an old married couple in real life, minus the sex, obviously. But
I really love the show.
Oh, good on you. Thank you.
I've got a question. In our office, we've got a thing going on where the people that have been the edge for a long time, we call ourselves old edge, and we're like, well, old edge wouldn't do that. Do you and Angela do that on Shortland Street? We're like, look, new Shortland Street. Old Shortland Street,
no,
you're doing
no,
it like this.
No, we just push them down the stairs. If they're too good looking, we'll throw battery acid in their face if they're too good looking.
Oh, look out.
Tough question from the text machine. Did you feel like a dick when you sang that shit song, Anchor Me?
Oh, hey, look, it's a great song. I did not do it justice, and yes, I felt like a dick, but it's a great song. Don McGlashan is a genius, and I'm sorry I ruined his song, but I did my best.
Because around that whole head injury thing, you had to do some weird stuff.
Yeah, I know. I loved it.
Yeah, because it was a bit outside the square
just
for you.
I found it hilarious. Yeah.
Is that what people were mimicking some of the things you had to say when they saw you around those scenes?
No. You mean on the street?
Yeah.
No.
Someone texted in, did you get annoyed with Guy taking the piss out of you every week on John on Bennett 10?
No, I don't watch the show.
Good answer.
I'm sure it's a great show, and that's their job, and it's fun, and it's advertising for the show, and I think it's great, you know. It's hard being funny, you know, and they are funny.
Oh, I know. I absolutely know.
I think they do a great job, so all power to them.
Oh, that's a lovely way of putting it. Such a nice guy.
If you could bring any Shortland Street character, dead or alive, you can pick one male, one female. I already know who mine would be.
Me too.
Who would you bring back?
Oh, I would bring back Greg Feeney, who's like my best mate, Tim Balm. He was the guy that sold Chris drugs.
Carmen's
brother.
He
was like bad, and he ran off with Greer Robson. Yeah, Carmen's brother.
Love him.
Yeah, actually, and Carmen I'd bring back.
Yep,
yeah, Teresa Healy. Yeah, she was awesome.
She was so funny.
Someone texts in saying, have, in your time being a doctor on Shortland Street, have you learnt any actual tips about being a doctor, and can you share them with us?
Definitely, definitely. I learn an awful lot because, you know, we have to do these procedures, we learn these complicated terms. The problem is I'm an actor, I have a brain of a goldfish, so the next week it's just all gone, you know. And in the moment I'm like, yeah, I know how to do this operation, and 2 days later I've forgotten.
How long does it take to film one episode?
It takes, on average, it takes a day to film an episode because we have to kind of keep up with what's on. But, yeah, that's what it averages out to. Yeah, a day to film an episode.
Okay.
Do you have the power, now that you've been there since 1992, do you have the power that if someone rubbed you up the wrong way on set, that you could just say to the writers, that Kylie, she's annoying me, kill her off?
I haven't tried that yet, but maybe I will.
You should. I reckon that you'd get away with it.
Here's a great question from the text machine. How much longer do you plan on staying on Shortland Street?
Forever. I absolutely love it. Sorry, everyone. That's a text.
You can't get a text on air, Michael.
I'm on call, you know. I'm a doctor.
Are you on? Oh, of course. Make sure you take that straight away.
Oh, my God.
What's wrong?
It's from Rachel. Rachel McKenna, yeah, it says, I know about the baby.
Oh my God.
You gotta go.
I'm out of here.
What will happen next week on Shortland Street? We have no idea, but that was Michael Galvin. Thank you to everyone for your questions for the AMA.
And don't forget, you can catch Shortland Street at 7 p.m. TV2 weeknights and the Omnibus on the weekend.
That was so cool.
Classic Michael Galvin, always leaving on a cliffhanger.
Guy, Sharyn and Clint.
On the edge.
Can I talk to you guys as friends for a second?
Sure.
You know how we just had Michael Galvin in for AMA?
Yeah.
You know how me and you ended up in dresses, Guy? We were the nurses and Sharyn and Michael were the doctors.
Yeah, I was a nurse / cowboy because I wore a cowboy hat as well.
I just went to the toilet. I had to go to the toilet before I'd taken this dress off.
Yeah, you've still got the dress on for some weird reason.
I thought I'd take the opportunity to do a sit-down wee in a dress.
God. Oh, God.
Liberating.
Okay.
It was just a very interesting... quite brisk up my skirt, too. It's so weird.
It's made you all floaty.
Pull my little panties down.
Tomorrow, Clint will be wearing a dress again, and we'll be like, why are you still in that? He's like, I'm still wearing it from yesterday's interview, guys.
All I'm saying is new experiences, guys.
Guy, Sharyn, and Clint
on the edge.
Who's ready for a groundbreaking segment? This is called...
You didn't wait to find out if we were ready.
Oh, sorry. You guys ready?
Yep.
Okay. I'm ready.
This is called, drum roll, everybody, the Long Weekend Chahoo!
Oh, you do a pretty good Chahoo.
Thank you.
Welcome to the future of radio, guys. This is the best segment that's ever happened ever.
Basically, it is the long weekend and everyone is ready to get off work for a few days, unless you have to work over the weekend, which I feel very sorry for you for. We want you to call right now, 0800 The Edge, celebrate the fact it's a long weekend, and give us a big down the phone.
Is that all you have to do? Just ring up and chahoo into the phone?
It's not a complicated idea. It's pretty straightforward, to be honest.
It's pretty good. Why don't you guys give it a go? Sharyn, it makes you feel really excited about the weekend.
Let's each take a go. Sharyn, you kick us off.
Okay. It's a long weekend. Chahoo!
Pretty good. Guy, you can be next.
I'm a white guy and I've never done a chahoo before, so this could go terribly wrong. Let's check it out. Long weekend. Chahoo!
Hey! Nailed it.
Come on.
Nailed it.
Oh, get on me. Yeah.
Okay. Clint, your turn.
Hello, my name is Clint and I'm excited for the long weekend. Chahoo! Oh, not too good.
Let's see if Jason's any better. Jason, are you ready for your long weekend chahoo?
Chahoo!
Hey! Do you feel ready for the weekend now, eh, Jace?
Yes, I am.
Oh, yeah. What about you, Ricky? Long weekend chahoo?
Working Saturday.
Oh, for goodness sake. Well, Ricky, instead of a chaho, can I get a long weekend? Boo.
Boo.
It feels so much better if you chahoed, Ricky. Gosh, we got a lady on the phone. Jenny, long weekend chaho, girlfriend, give it a nudge.
It's the long weekend.
Winner!
Jenny, yours is awesome.
Jenny.
I know, man, I know.
Okay, we're going to do that. We're going to do this again. We are going to go to Josh. Then I'm going to do one. Guy's going to do one. Clint's going to do one. And then Jenny's going to finish it off. Are you ready for this, Jenny?
Yeah, all good.
Okay, here we go. Josh, long weekend chaho.
Chaho.
That was good. That was good. Sharyn, long weekend chaho. Chaho. Guy. Chaho. Clint.
Chaho.
Oh, God. Jenny, save us all. Long weekend.
Guy, Sharyn and Clint on the edge.
The wonderful, the amazing.
What
do we call you again? The
Chang Hung.
The master producer.
Senior producer, executive producer.
I'm the only producer.
Super producer. You're the Timberland of our show. You're the guy who stands in the studio and goes, hey, hey, hey.
And eats heaps of bananas, because when Timberland's in the studio, he eats like a dozen bananas.
Ching.
And he walks around and he's like, and he eats the bananas. If you don't believe me, look at Jay-Z's Fade to Black documentary.
Yeah, he also has a huge bottle of milk, am I right?
Yes.
So, Chang, how many bananas are you eating at the moment?
None.
We're going to need you to increase your banana intake, mate.
Potassium.
If you want to look like Timberland, more bananas, more milk, less candy.
I just want to be rich like him.
Okay. That's a good
goal, mate.
Aspiration.
Not for now, though. You're poor.
Guy, Sharyn and Clint. Itch. For you are the wind
beneath my wings. Every Friday, we finish the week with Chang Hung's Wind Beneath Your Wings.
I cannot remember where I saw this from, but I had it written on my phone.
Oh, great.
Yeah, I cannot remember exactly where I saw it from. It says...
I'm looking forward to what it is.
You just repeated yourself, and both times you sounded very Asian. Carry on.
I am Asian, though.
Yeah, fair enough.
What's wrong with this?
So represent. Kia kaha, mate.
Sharyn, you all right?
Yeah.
We're all good.
Okay, so it says, without pain.
Just do it.
Focus.
She finished the giggling first.
No, she can't. She's got a problem. She's got a giggle disorder. Go, without pain.
Without pain, we could not know joy.
Ah.
Yeah. Oh, what are you
So that you can feel some joy.
Sharyn just punched Chang, and now he feels so much joy.
Guy, Sharyn and Clint. Edge.
There you go. That's the podcast. Thank you for joining us. We're going to take 3 days off now. Go and have a
No,
long...
we're not. We're going to be here tomorrow for the Fat 40.
I meant 3 days off the podcast.
Oh, right.
Yeah. What are you doing, mate?
Fart sounds.
Why?
Bit of a laugh, bit of comedy.
Farts are real
it's
funny.
It's hard to believe you won the Billy T sometimes.
I won an award for comedy. I never claimed to be good.
Before we leave, can we have a little preview to...
Oh, can we have a preview to the Fat 40 tomorrow? Yes. The Daffy Ducks.
Yes, can you do your Daffy
Yes,
Duck
we've got a segment tomorrow that we've already planned for the Fat 40.
Oh, God.
Where Guy and Clint are going to have a Daffy Duck off, but I think they need to practice. So you guys have a wee practice now.
Clint, you need to be Donald Duck, but Clint? Guy can't say Donald Duck, so it's Daffy
Clint,
Duck.
Clint, you do your Daffy Duck first, mate.
Donald Duck.
That's pretty good, but I noticed you didn't say, hi, I'm Daffy Duck in any of that.
I can't.
So mine's more like this. Hello, I'm Daffy Duck. How are you guys going today?
Mine's this one. Hang on, I need to warm up.
I don't think you'll be able to top mine, mate.
That's a book spinning real fast because I'm a cartoon.
All right, okay, yep, thank you.
I feel like we're all going to benefit from three days off or two days off. I've got my Donald Duck impression.
Oh, God.
Okay. No, wait.
You're actually worse than me, mate.
Kill me now.
We thought I was the worst in the world. You've seen the low bar and you've
that
gone
was
under
good.
It.
See you guys. Hang up the microphones when you're done.
Stop listening to the podcast now, guys. Stop listening. We'll do some better stuff next time.
The Guy, Sharyn and Clint podcast.